Lamberson, and today I'm going to show you how to make a black cat. It's just a simple one, but I'm trying out a new angle, so I wanted to see how it worked for filming also. I am starting out with a 1/16 mandrel and black. This is ecotray black. And we're just going to make a gather onto the mandrel, and we're also seeing how well you can see this while I'm making it. You can probably tell that I'm a lefty. That makes a little bit of a difference. I'm not sure. So I'm laying the black glass down onto my mandrel. And the way I do it is so that the glass is going on straight up and down. If you add glass to a mandrel on an angle, then you get those sharp edges sometimes, and that doesn't work out quite as well. And I heat my glass underneath the flame primarily. Part of it is that I have a little more control that way, so that works out well. Okay, so I'm going to keep working. And you can see I have a minor torch that I'm using, a Nortel minor, which I love. I have lots of other torches and I love them also. My minor, I use an awful lot of the time. It just kind of is plenty for a lot of what I do, although I do have some bigger torches just as well. And I am heating my glass. What I'm doing is while I'm turning it, I'm watching to see whether I have any shadows. If you have shadows, that means that that glass isn't as evenly heated as the glass that's bright orange. I'm just turning it around and I'm watching the shape of it. So now that that's under control and it's cooled a little bit, then I can start in on the next part. I'm going to give it a nice long neck. It's kind of a stylized black cat, kind of mid-century modernish. And I do sections at a time. Usually I do the thickest section first when I'm working in sculpture. That way, as it's heating and cooling, there's a little bit more mass and it's less fragile than if I did the other kind first, the thinner parts first. So we have a body and a neck, and I always work up and down, so the head will be up here, the body's down here, and this is kind of the way it's easiest for me to go and look at it and go, okay, this is where I am on it. So let me add the head. This one was just an oval. This is a slim barrel that I attached to it. And next, it's going to turn out kind of like a wide cone for the head. I like to exaggerate the length of the neck on this. It's kind of a little more fun. If you've made your neck too big, you could start at the top of the head and work your way down on the neck. So I am working in my Atlanta, Georgia studio, which is really a modified sun porch. You can see my kiln behind me. And the piece of equipment that my husband treasures the most, my container for my tools and stuff. Although, you can't see right above me, I have a lot of tools hanging on a very, very strong magnetic rack. And those are easy because I could just lift up and pull them down while I'm working, and I love that. So I'm going to heat up. This is a basic shape for a cat. I bet you never knew that. But it works, let me tell you. Anyhow, so I'm going to heat this up and flatten it slightly. I have some parallel mashers that are just a nice medium size. So I'm watching the color of my black glass. And I'm just going to give it a gentle press. And decide whether I want to add glass anywhere or whether I like this shape. So this part came down a little bit too far on the head, and I'm going to change that. I'm just going to take my hot glass, I'm going to heat it up, and just push up and in to extend the neck. You can see on one side where I pushed up and in, and we'll do the same after I heat up the rest of my glass to make sure it doesn't get too cold. Do the same thing on this side, pushing up and push in. taking the chill marks off from when I pressed it also. And chill marks are those really cool looking lines that you see around your glass after you've used generally a metal tool on it, sometimes graphite. And although I like them, you don't always want them on your piece, so it's good to take them off unless you're sure you're going to use them. So we're just doing a stylized black cat. Let me add a couple of ears. And the ears are dots that I'm just going to pull up, and I do them on the very outside of the bead. So it's a good sized dot. I push in, pull up, and then I do the same on the other side. I heat up where I'm going to place the glass first. Heat up the glass, push in, pull up. And then I reheat the rest of the bead before I do anything else. So right now the ears are roundish, and we don't want them roundish with cats. We want them pointed. I'm taking my brass marver and just pressing in on each side. What I did was I waited until my glass was kind of cool before I did it so that I'd have more control. And again, the same thing. I'm heating up just one side of the ear first and pressing in. And see how already it just changes the shape of it so quickly. But I'm watching the colors all the time of the glass as it's hot. I want to be sure that it is the right temperature before I move it around. I'm pressing up just a tiny bit under the head. I'm heating it up and giving it a little more definition. And what I did was, let me show you. I just heated up the glass along here. Let me see where you can see. Maybe I should have worn a white shirt. I heated up right below the neck and just pushed up like that on each side. So next, we want to add some little eyes, and these are going to be simple. We're just going to take some opaque bright green. I have a little stringer right here. I'm not sure which glass it is, but it's green or something like that that's opaque will work fine. You just want two little dots for the eyes. One dot. Two dots. And then I go back and reheat the bead. And at the same time, I'm heating just the tip of this. And then I'm going to pull it into a sharper point right here on the end of my mandrel. Flame cut, so it's still pretty sharp. If it's too long, don't forget how you can just push against something hard and break the edge off, because that works well too. So right now, I have two green dots, and while I'm talking to you, I'm heating the back of my bead. You see the two little green dots? Very simple. And I've got a sharpened end here. What I'm going to do is heat one dot at a time. See how I'm heating underneath the flame? Can you see that? By heating underneath the flame, I can just get that dot heated up, just it and nothing else. And I just took the corner and pulled a little bit. So I wanted the eyes to come up on a little bit of a slant. Do the same on the other side. You don't need to make them Siamese cat style, but just enough to kind of get the idea. And if you want, you can press them in or rearrange them. Mine are still slightly raised. And if you want to add a touch of black, you can too, to the center. I have a tiny bit of string right here. It's hard to see here. I'm going to hold it against my hand. Skinny little thing there. And what we're going to do is we're going to add the little dots in the center for the pupils. So first, this is even a little bit thicker than I would like. I'm going to take it and pull it into a finer point. I'm going to heat up the rest of my glass first. Because when you press it this thin, see how thin it is that I made it? When you press it like that, it's going to lose the heat pretty quickly. Okay, so each eyeball, I just heat up a little bit on my black stringer. Aim and press. Just a little bit. And you might notice how I rest picture helps me try to be steady. And sometimes that's not the easiest thing for me to do. Okay, so for another part of my cat, I would like to give it a collar. And I think that I have this kind of bright pinky color. It's rather attractive. I'll use that in a collar. And it's a case strimmer. So it has a transparent around the edge, which means that when I do little dots, the dots will stay a little bit more separate and won't run into each other quite as quickly. But it's a little bit thicker than I'd like, so I'm going to thin it out by heating it up and then pulling it off of the end of my mandrel again. And then I go back and heat up my bead. See how often I heat it up? It just kind of helps. Okay, so I want some of this around the edge. And it looks like I might need to strike it again. So just a little dot at a time. And going around the neck. And if I were taking too long, one of the things I would do, I'm just adding dots. One of the things I would do is go back and heat up my cat again, especially from the back side, because the back side's probably the easiest. And I'm going around in a circle with my dots. Cool a little bit, I'll go back and strike them. It looks like they need to be struck. So, I am back again to my cat, and the ears are a little bit not pointy enough for my taste, so I'm just taking a little point on the end of my black rod and pulling it up. I just pulled it up a tiny bit, and I'm going to let it cool, and I'll just break it off, and then use the heat to make sure that I don't have any leftover pieces on it that are sticking out. I'm going to do the same on this side. I just barely heated it up and pulled, and then I pause, waiting before I break it off. There we go. And the way that it cools, it pretty much takes care of it anyhow. You don't need to worry about it. Okay, so we're going back, and I'm heating up some black so that we have a tail. I'm not going to add legs this time. I don't think they're needed. So I'm just going to add a tail, and we're going to say this is a cat. Because oftentimes, and I know legs and paws are important for a lot of things, but this is just kind of a very stylized cat. I want a swirly tail on it that really shows up, and I want it to be easily worn. So I notice that one side comes out more round, and this one somehow is a little bit flatter. So I'm going to add it to the flatter side that will give the illusion of it being rounded out more. And I'm heating where I'm going to attach it. And notice the angle that I turn my mandrel. I'm just going to give it a nice little swirl. And I'm attaching it, the tail to the side just a tiny bit. And I'm letting it cool a bit, and then I'm going to let the flame cut off the end. And go back and heat one more time. And the funny thing is, as much as I wanted that pink to strike, it wouldn't strike. So it's just the way it is. And then we have a little cat for you to see, and very easy to do. I'm Marcy Lamberson. Don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. And you can find me on Facebook and Instagram under Marcy Lamberson. Hope to see you again. Bye.